Alright, so yes, it's Jeremy right here on 30 Minutes Live, and Charlie, this week has been trending. Everyone is talking about him for good reasons, for bad reasons, whichever reasons. Girl, them sugar.
What happened?
Kiddy, Charlie, this week, I'm sure you've not rested. You've
at
not
all.
Slept, not even a second. You've not even had time for.
At all. But it's all good, Charlie. It's part of the job, you know. We signed up for this, so.
But I know you personally, and I tell people that Kiddy takes things personal. He doesn't take things personal. I mean, he's just taking a very, slight way. I mean, no hard way. Kind of.
It's not deep. I mean, in the moment, it was deep, obviously, because.
It was deep?
Yeah, of course. In the moment, if you hope for something and you don't get it, as human as you are, I mean, go bash you small round, but you wake up in the morning, it's like,
I was like ah, kid, life goes on.
Yeah. I mean, it's not even the truth. I'm not gonna have, like, you know, deuterium and things, but no, the truth is the whole. These are people that they laugh self, for instance. Yeah, no, since back in the town, not since BGME. Every day, then go there, then go laugh somebody down there, you know. You say this year, catch my thing.
Catch your thing, people, they laugh you.
Oh, no, my go pass. This is a pass right now. Nobody is.
Anyway, we'll talk about VGM and all that. But let's talk about consistency. I mean, being relevant in the game to date. It's not easy.
Yeah.
For years now, dropping bangers every year, hits every year. I mean, in our industry, I know how people see it. Like, I mean, if you keep on dropping, people go like, I mean, one for you. But. You keep on dropping.
Yeah.
You keep on making it happen.
Yeah.
Still staying relevant.
Mm-hmm.
How do you make this happen?
It's just grace of God, because there's no formula. You can't say you have to do like this or like this to succeed. It's just, Charlie, we have to keep working hard and pray for the best, because, Charlie, it's a long journey ahead. And this, even the years we've gone, it's not even half of what we're yet to do. So we just have to always stay focused, stay consistent, make sure we continue working. We don't stop. We don't sleep. Because, Charlie, where would they try going on far?
Because people are not tired of hearing from you. I mean, if you drop a song, people want to know.
Yeah. And we keep, it's the same, like, you know, we keep switching it up with time, you know, touch it. It's very, it's like, nobody has helped somebody do anything like touch it. So it's like, hey, Kiddy can do that. You know, send me news, like, hey, what is it? The songs always have to have some elements of excitement, you know. So, I mean, that's what we'll keep doing, keep
touch
working
it.
Hard.
And bend over.
Yeah.
Hello, boys. Very bad boys. Anyway, let's talk about the Golden Boy album.
Yeah.
Why did you name it Golden Boy?
You know, I just have always felt like I'm special. I keep saying this, that since I was a child, man, I've always felt like I had something special in me. You know, the phrase Golden Boy also means like somebody who is special among a group of people.
Okay.
So I decided, I know what. We're growing in the music industry. The music is traveling little by little. So we're going to introduce ourselves to the outside world. You need to know who I am and where I'm coming from. So I'm the Golden Boy from Ghana, from Africa. So
is that the number 4 or number 5 album?
This is my second album, actually.
Second album?
Yeah.
But people think you have about 4 albums.
Yeah. There was one album, there was an EP, and then there's this album. So I have 2 albums, 1 EP.
I'm sure there are lots of people will be surprised hearing this is your second album. Looking at all the hits, all the songs, you'll be thinking you have more than 2.
No, it's just this is my second album. I know by the time I read 10 albums, Charlie, my name will be grand.
It's going to be crazy.
Yeah.
And this particular song everyone is talking about on the album, Send Me Nudes.
Yeah.
Whilst people are bashing your friends not to send nudes to with your partners,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You are saying
that
you send it.
Oh yeah, I encourage it. Nudity is different from nakedness. You have to understand. Nakedness, the way you hunt it now, but nudity, I can remove my t-shirt and just my chest is nude. You know, if I send that to some girl, to her, hey, Charlie, sexy. You know, so nudity is different from nakedness. That's what I want people to know.
So, so good you clarified that, because Charlie, somebody sent me news some hours back saying, did he say make you send news to
me? So they are doing a record. I mean, I'm just doing a record of the Lord, you know, I'm preaching the gospel.
Preaching the gospel?
Yeah.
Through nudity?
I mean, I'm making people spice up their marriages and relationships. So I'm doing a work of the Lord. I'm spreading love.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When last did you go to church?
When last I go? It's been a minute, actually. During COVID time, you know, everybody had to like do live streams and things. I think I personally got very comfortable in doing live stream at home. I felt like it was the same as physically going there, because it's the same message, the praise and worship. So, I mean, I do the live stream from home, and it's fine.
Now you took this album listening session too, all the way to home.
Yeah.
Where from that? How come? Why did you decide to do it in COVID?
Charlie, I'm an African man. I always believe in going home to, you know, get the powers, you know, from home. So it's just something I decided to do differently from what we always do. every time we're in Accra, 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 Accra. It's like, this one time, let me actually go to my hometown and, you know, do the listening there, let people experience it from there before we come and drop it in Accra. So that's what's the whole mind behind it.
All right. And then listening, I mean, one particular picture that was trending was between you and Selma Moomin. I mean, Selma, this is not the first time I'm seeing Selma around you. It looks like you have
she's,
videos.
She's my good friend. She's my good friend.
Just a good friend.
Yeah, she's a good friend. You know, anytime a guy is with a girl, be a, what do you say? What do you say?
So just...
Yeah, it's just friends. I mean, she's a good friend. She supports my music. And when I called upon her to come and listen to the album, I called upon a couple of people, but you know, some of them cancelled and stuff. But she came through, you know, she listened, she showed support. So I'm really grateful.
Yeah. All right. We'll talk about the VGM, the entire experience over there, all the noise and the trolls and all that.
Yeah.
But before that, let's talk about the Wanda Features Part 1.
Spiritual. Yeah.
Spiritual.
Yeah.
Look at the video, classic.
Yeah.
I wish I could know the cost of this particular video. A lot of things that went into this particular video.
I cannot tell people, but like, if you see, you can realize that actually it took an arm and a leg. And I mean, it's good because we always want to take our art to the next level. People need to watch us and feel like, yeah, we're serious about what we're doing. So, and sometimes these things come in the videos. People need to watch the video and even love the song more. You get it, so.
Showed us the location of this particular video because it didn't look more of Ghanaian.
Oh, we shot everything in Ghana. Accra, the Octagon in Accra.
Mm-hmm.
We shot some in East Legon, Chasako. We shot some around Ship.
Everything Ghana here, all the scenes were shot right here in Ghana.
Alright, so enough of the talking right now. Let's drop this particular video, Kili featuring Part 1 and Kwame. Let's get spiritual right here on the screen. Stay tuned, we'll be right back. So in case you just tuned in, this is 13 Minutes Live. Still hanging out with the girl Dem Sugar, Kili right here on 13 Minutes Live. Now let's move straight to the VGM experience.
Yeah.
Before you were going to the auditorium on that night, how hopeful were you?
I mean, I knew I'd worked hard under the year under review. I was hopeful that at least I was going to walk home with something. Because I had like 9 nominations, you know, so I knew if Menya crowd at least 1 or 2 BD, I have to take home. You know, I was hopeful, I was excited, I was nervous, all of that in one, you know. So I'm happy at least I walked out with 4 awards
exactly.
That night.
Yeah. You walked out with 4?
Yeah.
Share with us.
Highlight Song of the Year, Afrobeat Song of the Year, Afrobeat Artist of the Year, EP of the Year. Yeah, so.
And unfortunately, you couldn't win the Artist of the
that's
Year.
Unfortunate. That was unfortunate.
A tie between you and Dinah Hamilton, actually. And there's this one subject matter in the industry that's going on. You won a 3 Music Awards. VGMA gave it to Dinah Hamilton. Well, rumors going around is that VGMA didn't want to give it to Kiddy just to justify 3 Music Awards because he won that on that night. These are 2 rivals.
Really? Me, I thought, I didn't even know they were rivals.
That's what's going on.
They're always supporting each other in the industry.
Exactly.
If that's actually the reason, I'll be very disappointed. Mm-hmm. If that is the reason. Mm-hmm. But if it's not, I mean, I keep saying that things happen. And I believe it wasn't meant for me to take it. It was meant to happen the way. Certain things have happened in my life over the years that I've come to realize that everything that happens is meant to happen like that. You know, as human as we are, when things happen, we might be sad and angry. Oh, why didn't this thing go my way? Why didn't I do? And then later in life, you come to something else happens and make you realize that, yeah, it was supposed to happen like that for something to happen, for something else to happen. So I believe that if it was really meant for me to take it, I would have. So it was Auntie Dinah's night to take it. She's taking it. Hopefully my time will come soon. I also take it, and nobody can stand in my way when it's my time.
But your time was good on the 3 Music platform.
Wasn't that enough for you
winning the Artist of the Year on the 3 Music?
I mean, it's like I said, grateful, super grateful. Like winning overall 3 Music Awards, Charlie, is a big honor for me, and it shows that Charlie means people actually are watching and paying attention to what I'm doing.
Yeah.
Grateful, but you know there are so many other awards. So if I pick it here, I don't want to pick it here and lose here. I want to pick it here, pick it here, pick it here. And show people that yes, it's not that it's like maybe 3 Music loves Kiddy too much. Right. But 3 Music has recognized that Kiddy has worked. VGM has realized that Kiddy has worked. Once that everybody to realize that Kiddy has worked, exactly. So
let's talk about your performance on the night.
Yeah,
I mean, you have to see the showers of blessings and all that, all over you on stage.
It was good. I feel like it could have been better, but it was good still.
Something went wrong?
Not wrong per se, but every time I get off stage, I know I could definitely do better, you know, because we live, we learn from experiences on stage. You know, certain things will happen, certain things will go wrong, certain things will go right. Even when things go right, you can still make them better, you get me? So I'm just saying I could have done better, but I still had a lot of fun on stage with the dancers. We did a shutter, bend over, nice, like, it was a great time, it was a great time.
I did enjoy it, your costume was on point, as always.
Yeah. Golden boy thing, you understand?
And of course, it looks like you've met Dinah Hamilton
after the night, at some of the TV stations, and all that.
Share with us some of the moments. What did she say to you? What have you said to her?
I mean, I said the normal congratulations to her. I was glad I'd met her. We've never really spoken properly until now. So, like, I was glad to have met her. We gave each other a hug. She said, I'm a gentleman. Said I've exhibited good sportsmanship. And I'm so glad that such words are coming from such a renowned, you know, woman of God. So, I was grateful.
But yeah. People have a problem. You're saying that you've not heard her song before at all.
There's no problem. There are songs of mine that people too haven't heard before. I'll never take it personal.
Because, I mean, that's out there that you heard it for the first time at the VGM night.
Yeah. Actually, I know her other songs, Yesu Mo, like all, but for Adum Grace, I'd never really heard it. Maybe even if I've heard it, was passing and I've not really listened to the song before. But that night, I really fell in love with the song. Like, even the next day, I was playing the song on my live and stuff, yeah.
There's some few questions from our social media folks. Rahina Isaka from Legon Hills. Why didn't he come back after he said I'll be back? That's crazy.
No, yeah, I mean,
all right. And then Jaka from North Kaneshe, what are the inspirations behind his tattoos? How many tattoos do you have?
I think I have about 15 or 16.
15 or 16?
Yeah,
yeah. What tell us?
I mean, every one of them represents something in my life, with my life, going on in my life. So, like, my mom's name. Breathe it as well because of my anxiety a lot. So okay. There's that, there's the Dinkra, there's my son's birthday, I'm blessed, there's a message of the cross, there's the year of birth, there's Zane's name, my sugar albums, like Golden Boy. So it's just things that are happening around me in my life. Yeah.
That's crazy. 15, 16 tattoos.
Yeah. It's not Coco, hey Appa. I don't even know why I keep doing it, but
But our cracker guys boy.
Say what?
Why? Because if you go on stage, they say you didn't mention Bleo. You don't mention that.
Listen, make I tell you, make I tell you something. Make I tell you something. I don't will lie you. After the fourth award, I was confident because at that time I had won fourth. It looked like a ninth was going to be my ninth. So
you're waiting for the last one to mention Accra.
See, I had prepared a speech for my award at this end of the year. Hey, it's ready. I prepared a speech about, like, I was going to start from my JSS, from my high school, my uni.
Hey.
I was like, the speech was prepared, you know, like, I had like, so over me, but I mean, like I said, everything happens for a reason.
So Blow Boy is kind of easy on our brain. Yeah. Yeah.
If you say, it won't happen, that'd be right,
All right, and on the night when Mark mentioned you, Charlie Mark, or Hadrian, the way he mentioned it, did Kiddy say he'll be back?
Did Kiddy say he was going to come back? Is Kiddy here? Are you coming back? Because Dinah Hamilton will not permit you to come back.
It really made them get to me. Hey, them get to me.
Said that today be what? Today be Sunday. Then I'm sure it clicked your mind that.
Yeah, when he said Sunday, and I knew I was going to church. I knew that word was going to church. I knew it.
All right, yes, we're still hanging out with Man Kiddy right here on the show. I guess you're enjoying yourself. And of course, we're also enjoying ourselves right here on 30 Minutes Live. Let's talk about that.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a crazy song.
Crazy jam, man. It's doing amazing. We already passed 2 million views.
Exactly.
And on TikTok is wild. Some of the videos, you know, it's coming from all over Africa, all over the world. And I couldn't be more glad. As an artist, like, these be the things we like, actually. When we make music, the music for travel beyond our shores, make it go, make it do things for us, you get me? So I'm really excited for what it's doing. It showed me that it's more a bad pun.
Exactly. What's the reason behind it? The lyrics? Because touch it.
Bend
over.
I want you to, you know, shut up and bend over, you know, because.
Maintenance.
In the club, whenever I'm in the club, I realize that, you know, a lot of people, when they drink small, they want to be bad, you know, they want to do things, they want to dance. So I had that in mind that. When a song drops in the club,
no play TikTok.
Debbie. Man, Kasa. Let's do the do.
Anyway, so who recorded the song?
I did myself. I recorded my. I produced it myself. I wrote it myself as well. So Shouts to me.
Alright, okay. So let's drop that banger right here on the show. When we are back, we'll talk about the video, the making of the video actually, any album, EP, what's next for the man. Kiddy right here on the show. Stay tuned. You have to shut up and enjoy 30 minutes every now and then right here on your screens, because we bring you your favorite stars right here on your screens. And the making of the video, tell me more. This is more of a lab. Were you a science student back in school?
No, actually,
what's up with this lab definition of tenor?
We're cooking the duchy, you know, we're cooking the banga in the lab. So, you know, I was in my lab, I have my lab technicians around me.
Oh, the ladies
twerking,
around
you know. Work was over, so you know they were twerking, and it was that video was so
fun. But where did you get this concept from? Why did you take the love to the lab?
It's symbolism of cooking bangers, you know. We call our studios a lab. We always cook everything we cook in the studio. We cook bangers, we cook, you know, songs in there. So it was a symbolism of what has been cooking and what was yet to come. So when the lab cooking the bangers, we're cooking the duchy as well. And you know what a duchy is, you know, we're cooking it.
Yeah. Yeah. Charlie, we had what the, time is it? 47
And we had the circus scene as well when I was a magician. I had my girls with me. Yeah. It was a really fun video to shoot. Yeah.
What happens to be your favorite scene in there?
I think it was a lab scene. It was very, like, the energy when we were shooting it was even behind the scenes. Yeah, it was crazy. It was crazy.
I see. Rex shot it, I guess.
Yep, yeah, shout out to Rex, Charlie. He killed it.
And where did he shoot this?
We shot this in Achimota as well. Yeah, Tygon Studios.
Tygon Studios. Yeah. I mean, go on social media now. Look for Tygon Studios.
Yeah.
It's crazy. Multi-purpose.
Most of my virtual concerts have been shot there as well. So we do a lot of, you know, shooting around. Yeah.
Awesome. Charlie Tygon Studios, amazing. Anyway, what's next with you after dropping this?
It's out, right? The album is out. It's just promo. We're just gonna push it because it's been a few days. It's doing amazing. We wanted to go ahead and win album of the year next year. So we have a couple of videos coming from there as well. We're hoping that Charlie performances happen during the summer as well, so we can get to promo the album tours and all of that. But yeah, right now it's just the Golden Boy season. Everything we do is just the Golden Boy.
It's
going
to be the Golden Boy. You are associated with some of the brands. How is it doing?
So far, so good.
Brand ambassador.
Yeah, so far, so good, Charlie. I couldn't be more grateful. You know, Ghana here, we only make money through shows and, you know, brand endorsements. And right now, shows has been beans for a long time.
No,
you
know, yeah.
So I'm glad that, you know, the work we've done has been able to, you know, pin us with some brands, and I'm working with Samsung, I'm working with Fidelity. A new one is about to be announced soon as well. So Charlie,
congratulations.
Thank you. Charlie, you lift us up, and then these brands, we're attractive enough for these brands to want to work with us. So love to everyone.
What's your expectation on the next set of award shows? I mean, let's say next year VG or May3 Music. Mm-hmm. What's your expectation?
I mean, it's always about growth. That's the most important thing. Like, whatever was done this year, next year should always be better, bigger. So whatever the awards are planning for next year, performance wise, award wise, it should just be better than the year that's gone. So we're looking for better and wild things from 3 Music, from VGMA, from all of them. 4 Sides, everybody should, you know, step up, because Charlie, people are watching now, people are interested, people are, you know, so more grease.
But people get crazy questions. Somebody say you talk Sinaso for the VGMA Go Follow Jackie. Were you rolling with Jackie?
Sinaso wasn't there that night, actually. Okay. She was there on the Friday, but she wasn't there on the Saturday. And I met Jackie on the red carpet. You know her scenario address. I had to be a gentleman and help her out. Yeah, so you know, the deep.
People notice things too much.
There's a video on YouTube. I don't know who, I think it's Iron Felix or somebody posted it. And I was helping Jackie, and the floor was wet, and Jackie was like, oh, the floor is wet. And I was everywhere is wet. If you look at the comments, hey, Kiddy, everywhere is wet. Kiddy wants to spoil Jackie. No. But yeah,
lastly, what do you want to say to the girl, them sugars?
I want to say a big, big, big thank you, man. Not just the girls, like the men, them as well, everybody who's been supporting the media guys, TV7, Charlie, you guys, you've been holding me down from day one, Charlie. God bless you. God bless you guys so much. Love to everybody. The Golden Boy album is out. Keep streaming, keep supporting. Like, love, man.
Touch it
and bend over. Hey.
Kiddy, it's a pleasure to have you right here on the show. It's been great coming your way. It's been very insightful. Of course, it's a VGMA experience. And all that you wanted to know about the man Kiddy, we got it right here on your screen for you. Stay tuned. I'll be back to wrap up right here on the show. Stay on.
Alright, so yes,
Incredible guy, of course. Ghana, Africa as a whole should support him. Kid, the amazing talent. 4 awards on the night. And of course, he deserves some congratulations, not all the trolls and all that people are just doing on social media. All right, so it's been great 30 minutes right here on 30 Minutes Live. We brought you an insightful interview with myself and Kiddy. And shout out to you once again, Elicio Clothing. Go on social media platform now. And of course, Sales Fabric for providing the fabrics. Sales Fabrics on social media. And of course, they team up to make me look good right here on your screen. Next week, I'll definitely come your way with another super good guest in your homes. I'm DNA, and of course, this is 30 Minutes Live.